Like and subscribe right now, or you're going to have bad luck for the rest of the week. The most common way in which most land animals, such as lions, monkeys, and dogs, for example, give birth is similar to the way humans do, by directly giving birth to their younger ones. Such animals are classified as viviparous animals, while most other living creatures, such as most fish and birds, give birth by laying eggs and are, therefore, called oviparous animals. However, there is one other way in which animals give birth that you are likely to be unfamiliar with, by growing from a segment of the original animal. This process of reproduction is called budding. While there are different birthing techniques for different animals, there are further variations among them. Number 10. Sea turtles. We are all aware of the reputation of turtles finding it hard to move on land due to their lack of proper limbs. Therefore, they're extremely slow. They move much more freely in water using their webbed paddle-like feet. However, turtles prefer to give birth in the more difficult way, on land. They dig holes in the beach sand to form a nest and lay their leather-textured eggs there. However, they do not choose any random beach to lay their eggs on. When they are about to give birth, these turtles swim many miles to return to the same beach where they were born to lay their eggs. While many of the hatchlings are devoured by predators, those who manage to escape to the sea return back to their birthplace when it is their time to give birth. This characteristic of sea turtles leads to a fascinating event known as arribada, meaning arrival, in a Costa Rican beach where tens of thousands of turtles gather each year during October to lay their eggs. Number 9. Crocodiles. We all know that the gender of a human baby cannot be predetermined. Whether it will be a male, female, or any other gender is based on chance. However, this is not true for all animals. Like all reptiles, crocodiles are amphibians who lay their eggs on the ground rather than in the water. They make their nests close to the riverbank, and the mother usually stays close by to protect their offspring. The interesting fact, however, is the gender of the hatchlings depends on the location of the nest. When the temperature is higher than 34 degrees centigrade, androgenic hormones are formed inside the egg, resulting in a male baby. However, in lower temperatures, these hormones do not form, and the offspring is born as a female. Therefore, a nest under the bright sun would produce male crocodiles, whilst one under a shade is likely to hatch female ones. Number 8. Snakes. As we commonly know, most oviparous animals lay eggs and protect the eggs until the offspring are developed enough to come out. However, surprisingly, some animals do not lay their eggs, even if the baby is ready to hatch. The garter snake is one such animal that retains the eggshell inside the mother's body rather than laying it. Such animals are known as ovoviparous animals. The hatchlings remain inside the body of the carrier and continue to grow there. These babies do not receive any food or oxygen from their mother during this time, like most mammals do. When the little ones are mature enough, they are laid by the mother. By the time they come out, they are already strong enough to fend for themselves, instead of being, essentially, helpless if born from eggs outside of the mother. Number 7. Frogs. Many amphibians, such as frogs and toads, who are able to breathe on both land and water, are known for their peculiar eggs. When we hear the word egg, we often think of a hard shell protecting the offspring that is developing inside. However, amphibian eggs are a bit different than you would imagine. Their eggs do not have a hard shell, but instead are laid in a group and have a jelly-like texture. A common toad, for example, can lay masses from 3,000 to 6,000 eggs at a time. They lay their vulnerable eggs on tiny, shallow pools of water and puddles, in water trapped in tree branches, or captured between leaves. Interestingly, the poison dart frog is known to carry their newly hatched tadpoles on their backs, giving the young frogs a piggyback ride from the trees to water sources on the ground. Number 6. Cabbage aphids. Cabbage aphids are strange-looking bugs that are one of the most common pests of indoor plants. These destructive green bugs have a whitish appearance and are found feeding on cabbages and other brassicas. While most species require a male and female to reproduce, female aphids do not. They have the ability to produce genetic copies of themselves and can give birth to up to 10 offspring in a day. In fact, research carried out through microscopes has shown that the first embryo of the next generation can be seen inside a female aphid as soon as they are born. The eggs hatch inside the carrier's body just like in reptiles discussed earlier. During the mating season, male aphids are also born, which allows genetic diversity to take place. The females lay their eggs this time, which then hatch during the spring season. Number 5. Spiders. You might think spiders are the scariest of creatures judging by their appearance, but the truth is that they are one of the most caring mothers in the world of insects. While spiders lay eggs normally, what is fascinating is the way in which they take care of these eggs. Firstly, the spiders make a sac using spider silk where they keep all their eggs. While some spiders keep this sack of eggs hidden underground or store them in their webs, some of these eight-legged creatures carry them around with them. For example, nursery web spiders use their mouths to carry the egg sac around. On the other hand, woof spiders can be seen to attach the sack of eggs on their spinneret and carry the unhatched eggs around. When the offspring comes out, they climb onto their mother's back and enjoy a piggyback ride for the first few days. When they are strong enough, they climb down their mother's backs and start off on their independent lives. Number 4. Seahorses. It is common knowledge that the carrier of a baby, or the parent that gets pregnant, is always the female one, whether it is a bird, fish, or any other type of animal. However, this role is reversed in the case of seahorses. During the process of reproduction, the female seahorse leaves her eggs in the male seahorse's special brood pouch. The eggs are fertilized there, and the male carries them around during the entire period until they are ready to hatch. After nearly 20 days, the male seahorse gives birth to more than 1,000 seahorse babies. However, this is not always the case, as the eggs are sometimes seem to be attached to the male's tail. Surprisingly, seahorses are not the only ones to give birth in this peculiar manner. The pipefish and leafy sea dragons are also known to give birth in a similar way. Number 3. Coral reefs. Coral reefs may not look like a living thing and may certainly not feel like it when they're touched because of their stony texture, but it is actually an animal. In fact, they reproduce in a fascinating way. Once a year, during the spawning season, a single coral releases millions of eggs called polyps over a span of 2 days. Out of the millions of eggs that the coral produces and releases, approximately 2 of them can actually survive to adulthood. This is because as soon as the eggs are released, the filter feeders come to feed on the eggs and larvae. And for this reason, their system of reproduction is criticized for being too risky. These creatures can, however, produce both asexually and sexually. Just like a starfish, a broken coral fragment is enough to reproduce another by regenerating. Number 2. Suriname toads. We have already discussed the peculiar texture of eggs that frogs and toads lay on shallow bodies of water earlier in this video. However, we are going to talk about the unusual system of reproduction of a Suriname toad, also commonly known as the star-fingered toad. Unlike most male aquatic animals who croak, Suriname toad males make a clicking sound underwater to call a female toad for mating purposes. The female one releases about 60 to 100 eggs, and after fertilizing these eggs, the male toad pushes all of these eggs onto the back of the female parent. These eggs stick to her skin, and over time, a layer of skin grows over these eggs as a form of protective layer for the developing tadpoles, which look similar to an irregular honeycomb. During this time, the embryos go through their tadpole stage and come out as fully developed toads after nearly a week. The baby toads squirm out of a cluster of very tiny holes situated in the back of the mother toad. Number 1. Cichlids. Unlike all the various other methods discussed in this video in which animals lay their eggs, this one is probably the strangest method. Cichlids are fish from the large family of Cichlidae, which include fishes like tilapia and angelfish. The male fish digs a nest and lures in the female by doing a strange fin-shaking dance. The female lays her eggs in the nest and the male fertilizes them, which is a very common method of reproduction as it is done by most fish. However, what happens after is that the female picks the eggs up and places them in her mouth. She carries them around for about 2 weeks until the eggs hatch. Nevertheless, the mother may still continue to carry them around for a further 2 weeks, only occasionally letting them out to feed themselves if the environment feels safe. If the slightest threat appears, the mother will suck the babies right back in. A new mother can be seen to carry about 10 young ones in their mouths, while the more mature mother can be seen with 30 of them. That is all for today's video. Thank you all for watching. While you're here, go ahead and click on one of these two videos on your screen. See you there!